Hi everyone, welcome to my Real Estate Tax Tips channel. My name is Cherry Chen, a chartered professional accountant located in Ontario, Canada. I want to become the Google Map for Canadian investors seeking financial freedom. This is the second video in a series dedicated to understanding investing in a TFSA account, explaining everything you need to know about the tax-free saving accounts. Now, in this particular video, I'm going to cover the top 5 investments you don't know that you can make from your TFSA. Number 1, private lending. Number 2, private real estate investment trust. Number 3, land development investments. Number 4, selling covered calls on shares that you already own. Number 5, buying deep in the money call in replacement of the actual shares. In the future videos, I will cover other TFSA-related topics. If you have a specific question relating to TFSA, please leave them in the comment section below. Before I start, don't forget to like and subscribe to my YouTube channel so you can stay on top of my latest update. Many of our clients are real estate investors and real estate agents. They often ask me how they could potentially lower their tax liability and how they could use their registered funds to invest in real estate. What they're really asking me is, how do they maximize their return on investment within their registered accounts? Here are the little known 5 investment vehicles I've seen many of our investor clients use with their registered account. Number 1, private lending. Many of our clients have great success at lending money privately using the funds in their TFSA account. The return on investment ranges from the current mortgage rates offered by the bank to interest rates over 15%. You can also charge a lender's fees that the borrower pays upfront. This can be anywhere between 1% and 3%. The rate of returns is driven primarily by the risk involved. Obviously, the lower the risk involved, the lower the rate. So the interest you can charge on a first mortgage secured by a rental property usually is lower, and the rate of return is usually higher for an unsecured promissory note offered to a builder, as construction loan is generally riskier than a rental property with steady cash flow. The benefit of doing private lending is that you see cash flow deposited in your account consistently. Private mortgages are usually facilitated by a mortgage broker or a lawyer. It's a fairly passive way to invest as long as everything goes well with the borrower. If the borrower starts missing payments, you then have to initiate a power of sale process that can be expensive, and you may not want to own another rental property. Also, if you don't hold the first mortgage on the property, say you land as a second mortgagee, it can be harder to recover your investment. This is why picking the right borrower matters. Mortgage brokers can sometimes help with borrower screening. But if all goes well, you collect a lender's fee upfront, then a set interest rate each month. Many times, private mortgages will be paid out in full after 1 to 5 years. So you could have all the cash back in your TFSA account after a while, as well as all your profit, which is tax-free in your TFSA account. Number 2, investment in real estate investment trust. I personally have a very small investment in a private real estate investment trust, also known as private REIT. This private REIT uses the BRRR strategy. Buy, renovate, rent, and refinance for multi-unit residential building in Southern Ontario, and it provides about 6% cash-on-cash return annually. The minimum investment is about $25,000. To qualify to invest in this type of private REITs, you would typically have to qualify as an eligible investor in Ontario. And this means that you either need to have net assets of $400,000 or you make more than $75,000 income in the last 2 calendar years. If you're not qualified as an eligible investor, you can simply purchase real estate investment trust units trading in the stock market that provide consistent returns as well. Many REITs follow themes like medical buildings, malls, industrial buildings, or apartment buildings. So when you research the REIT that you are interested in investing in, you can pick one that invests in the sector you believe will continue to grow. Number 3, investment in land development deals. We also use our registered funds to invest in land development deals. Typically, these land development deals are set up as limited partnerships. Each investor would purchase limited partnership unit instead of shares. Again, the minimum investment is typically around $25,000. Similar to investing in private REIT, you are required to be an eligible investor in Ontario. Upside of investing in land development deals is that you get to share the upside of land development, which is substantial. It's like being the builder without all the work involved. Typically, the upside is substantial. The downside is that you won't see much of your cash flow during the investment period. As you know, land development usually requires a number of years to complete. This means that your money is tied up for the entire investment horizon. Another downside is that you might not be able to liquidate your investment easily. If you have no intention to withdraw your TFSA money anyway, investing in these land development deals can significantly enhance your return. This is some of the most passive investing you can do in real estate, and when you invest in your TFSA account, your gains are tax-free. Number 4, stock investment coupled with selling cover calls. We all know that we can invest in the stock market using our TFSA funds. What you might not know is that you could enhance your return by selling options against shares that you own in your registered account. Say you bought 100 shares of Cineplex, also known as CGX, back in January at $10 per share. At the time of recording, CGX is worth almost $14. Now, CGX is a stock that does not pay dividends. If you want to enhance your return on investment, you can choose to sell an option called cover calls against the 100 shares that you own. By selling the cover call option, you agree to sell the CGX shares at a predetermined price at a specific date. Say you want to sell CGX at $15 per share, you can choose that $15 as a strike price and then choose an expiry date. Someone may be willing to pay you upfront for the right to buy your CGX shares at $15. Let's say they pay you 50 cents per share for the right to buy CGX at $15 by September. 50 cents multiplied by 100 shares, you get $50 deposited into your TFSA account immediately. If CGX is about $15 when the expiry date arrives, you keep $50 and your shares are called away. You are paid $15 per share. If CGX is below $15 when the expiry date arrives, you keep the $50 and the shares stay in your account. Then you get to write another cover call all over again. For the real estate investors out there, selling cover call is kind of like rent to own. You collect an option consideration upfront and agree on the future sale price. If the tenant buyer carries through with the sales, you've made money on the option consideration fee and profit on the sale price. If they don't buy the house, you could find another tenant buyer and collect another option consideration fee. Back to stocks and registered funds. Doing cover calls over and over again effectively reduces your cost basis for CGX. Your purchase price is $10, your cover call premium is 50 cents per share, new cost base for your share is $9.50. When you eventually decide to sell your CGX shares, the return on investment will be higher. Let's look at another example. This time we'll use TELUS, ticker T. TELUS is a much bigger company than Cineplex. They have been around longer and their stock price is much less volatile. It doesn't fluctuate as much. For this reason, the premiums for T calls aren't as attractive. But TELUS is a dividend-paying stock with a dividend rate of 4.5% as of this recording, and it's considered a relatively safe stock to hold. It will be hard for a cell phone carrier to go out of business too fast. Let's say you bought 100 shares of T back in January for $26. At the time of recording, T is almost worth $28. Maybe you're willing to let go of your T shares at $30 per share. How much is someone willing to pay you to buy your shares at $30? Well, the length of a call contract matters. Usually, the further out the expiry date is, the more the premium will be. In this case, if you want to collect at least 25 cents per share for your $30 call on T, you have to set the expiry date for December 2021, about 140 days away. See how much harder it is to find similar premiums for T compared to CGX. That's because T is much less volatile than CGX. Okay, so you now have a December cover call at $30 for 25 cents per share. Let's do the math. Purchase price, $26. Cover call premium, 25 cents times 100 shares, which is $25. Your average TELUS cost is now $25.75. Sure, that's not a big impact, but you bought T shares to hold long term anyway. Maybe you get to sell cover calls 3 times a year. That means you could reduce the cost of your shares by $75 every single year. Not bad. Number 5, stock option trading, also known as buying deep in the money call. There is a way to profit from stock price growth in your TFSA account without actually owning stocks. And this strategy actually lets you control the stocks at a fraction of the stock price. It's called buying deep in the money call. In the previous example, you sold cover calls using your shares as collateral. Well, you could also buy a call as well, but you don't have to have shares in your account for that. Let's use Scotiabank with the ticker symbol BNS for this example. If the current price of BNS is $78, you may be able to buy a call at the $60 strike price with an expiration date that is way out. January 2023. That call contract could cost you $18 per share. Because every option contract is 100 shares, the total cost of that call contract is $1,800. You now have control of 100 shares of BNS and you've only paid $1,800 versus $7,800 that it would have cost to buy shares outright. The best outcome in this case is that BNS continues to increase in value over the next year and a half. Just for the sake of illustration, let's say BNS doubles in value by then. Your call contract would also roughly double as well, and you could sell the contract at $3,600. You just capture all of the movement of BNS, 100% return on investment, but only invested about 23% of the cost of actual BNS shares. And because you bought and sold that call in a TFSA, the profit isn't subject to tax. Something important to note, you don't collect dividends when you hold a call option. So if you're looking for dividends, buy the shares outright. You may want to buy deep in the money calls only on stocks that don't pay a dividend, so you're not missing out on any cash flow. However, if you're looking for efficient use of your TFSA funds, then deep in the money calls may work for you. Cool little strategies, eh? This is why we call it stock hacking. And this is also why my husband, Erwin, and I teach stock hacking to as many people as we can. We want everyone to know these strategies. If you want to find out more about stock option trading strategies, you can go to stockhackeracademy.ca. Okay, I've covered a lot today. You've learned about the top 5 investment that are allowed in TFSA. Number 1, private lending. Number 2, private real estate investment trust. Number 3, land development investments. Number 4, selling covered calls on stocks you already own. Number 5, buying deep in the money calls in replacement of stock shares. If you found this video useful, make sure you like and share with friends and families you think should know this stuff too. If you want to learn more about tax-free saving accounts or tax tips in general, make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel. If you have any questions relating to this video, make sure you comment below and I will personally respond to all your questions. One last thing, we are preparing a TFSA playbook to provide an overview of how TFSA works in Canada, the type of investments you can do to maximize your return on investment, and the landmines and mistakes that you probably want to avoid. This TFSA playbook will be available by the end of the summer. If you want to pre-order a copy now, visit tfsaplaybook.ca and download it for free. Thank you for watching.